you know, the fun part of it to me was when you looked, when you read the screenplay, although I have to say, just so we're clear, when Damon and Brad showed up at my house, they said, we've got a part we've written for you. And then I opened up the description of the character, and it's a 55-year-old has-been, you know, part of my reading book.
Genius, by the way. It said genius.
It said former genius, boy genius, who's gotten bitter in his old age. What I loved about the film was that it reminds you that, you know, young people don't wake up, they're not born and start out their lives cynical or angry or bigoted. You have to be taught all of those things. And I watch the world now and think, well, I see really good signs from young people out there. And I feel as if the world will get better. And I've always been an optimist. I've been a realist, but I've been an optimist about it. And that's, I really related to the film because I thought, well, Brad and Damon want to tell a story that's an entertainment, because first and foremost, it has to be an entertainment, but that is hopeful. I've always felt that way myself. So
we're talking about a movie that's saying we don't know what our future is, it's not determined for us, and maybe if we go out there and explore the world, maybe if NASA wants to go and see what else is out there, then maybe that'll have, you know, some helpful part in making our future something to be excited about.
The feeling was like, by directly referencing Disney and Disneyland in a movie that is a Disney movie, it just suddenly felt like, oh, are we trying to sell tickets to go to the theme park? When the theme park should be selling tickets to go and see Tomorrowland. But on his deathbed, he was looking up at the ceiling and pointing out how the city would be laid out. And the fact that he was, to his last moments, dreaming about this future and making crazy ideas happen and be real and accelerate the pace of that was very moving to me. And if the movie caught even a little bit of that, I think we will have succeeded.
But I do still sing them every once in a while to entertain the troops when they think it's really getting, you know, they think, that, gosh, it's, we're in the water, it's cold, we're shooting 14 hours, we've been out all night, it's terrible, what could be worse? And then Iraq.